Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Dokkan Battle video. So as you guys can see on the screen right now, Tech LR Jiren is going to be dropping on Global in exactly 1 day and 9 hours from the time I'm filming this video. Obviously, by the time this video comes out, it's going to be even sooner. The point is, he is coming very, very soon. So in today's video, I want to give you guys a quick preview of everything you need to know about this unit, from his super attack animations, to his banner, his new category, Universe 11, and of course the details for the unit itself, to hopefully help you guys decide whether or not you want to spend your hard-earned Dragon Stones to try and pull this unit, or if you want to hold on to them for something else in the future. Okay, so with all that said, let's just jump right into it. And the first thing we'll start with are the super attack animations that just released last night on the official Dokkan Twitter page. So let me just throw on some headphones here and let's check it out. Here we go.
Trust is for the weak. Strength is everything.
All right, so there you go. Those are LR Jiren's animations. Overall, I think they're really, really good. I mean, I like them. I know a lot of people are not like super high on these animations. I've heard a lot of like negative comments about it, and I don't really understand why, because to me, they look absolutely amazing. You know, like I put them in my top 10 best animations of 2020 from a couple weeks ago, and I think it was not super high, but maybe like 8 or 9 on that list. And considering how many amazing animations we got last year, I think that's still a very, very good placement, you know? So, I don't know, I'm a big fan. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about the animations. Maybe they're a little bit basic, maybe they're a little bit boring to you, but I enjoy them, you know? So those are Jiren's animations. And now let's pop over to the new Int Topo slash Pride Trooper animations before we move on to the banner. All right, so we're at the beginning, here we go. Yeah, so if it wasn't obvious, I'm a huge fan of all of these animations, especially the second one, actually. I forgot they included the animation for the Fizz, you know, Casserole slash Pride Troopers, the new free-to-play unit, and it's this one right here with all the poses. And dude, I love it when characters do this, man. It's the main reason why I love the Ginyu Force so much. So yeah, man, great animations all around. And of course, yes, it is a JoJo reference. It's gotta be. Everything is, right? Anyways, those are the animations. Now, let's pop over to the potential banner for Tech Jiren when he drops on Global. Now, of course, this is the JP banner, and there's no guarantee that the Global banner will look exactly the same, but based on, you know, historical data, based on the trend, it's most likely gonna be the exact same banner when it comes to Global. Okay, so here are the featured units, and of course we have LR Jiren himself. He is the main prize for this banner. If you're summoning here, you definitely want to see him appear in your summons, right? And besides him, we have the new Int Topo that Dokkan awakened into Topo slash Pride Troopers. And everybody else is old. They're existing units in the game, and they're all non-Dokkan Fest units, which means that they're essentially going to be available on every other banner in the game. And for that reason, a lot of people are kind of hesitant to summon on legendary summon banners because there really isn't anything that's considered limited, right? Like for Dokkan Fest banners, we have Dokkan Fest exclusive units that are only available on Dokkan Festival banners, and some of them don't come back for many, many months. Like Int Future Gohan, for example, didn't come back for 9 months after his initial release. Obviously, that's an extreme example, but the point is Dokkan Festival units are definitely more exclusive, I guess, than these non-Dokkan Fest units. But with that said, this is actually a very solid banner for a Legendary Summon banner, because we have some amazing units like AGL Fit Boo, STR Topo with the Extreme Z Awakening becomes one of the best supports in the entire game. AGL Dispo is a very good unit too with his EZA. We have Fizz Bergamo, we have Fizz Super Saiyan Blue Goku, awesome unit too. We have Int Ribrianne, who for the Peppy Gals team is fantastic, especially because she's actually the best leader for that category right now. And these guys, the Boda Maketa and the Frost, are okay units. They're not actually that impressive, but still usable for sure. And STR Whis too is a very good unit for Super Battle Road, and also just a overall great support unit if you have Beerus on the team. So, like I said, for a Legendary Summon banner, I mean, I feel like Legendary Summon banners are just not great value for your stones in general. Like, they're not great banners to summon on, but if you had to summon on a Legendary Summon banner and you're missing at least like half of these featured units, then this actually isn't half bad, you know? So if I were to grade it on a scale of 1 to 10, I would give this one like maybe a 6, 6.5. I mean, obviously it depends on how many of these featured units you have, how many of them you still need dupes for. If you have all of them rainbowed, then the value is obviously significantly lower, but if you do need some of these side units, then it's not too bad, okay? So yeah, 6, 6.5, a normal Legendary Summon banner, I usually give like a 4, you know, 4.5, 5 maybe, right? So yeah, I would call this a above average Legendary Summon banner, especially because of how much of a monster Jiren is. That's also something else we need to take into consideration, right? Because this is going to be our best chance to pull this tech LR Jiren. He will be back in the future as an unfeatured unit on other banners, but your chance of pulling him is going to be much, much lower. All right, so yeah, that is the banner for you. Most likely no changes for the global side. And now let's pop over to the details for Jiren himself. And his leader skill is Universe 11 category, Ki plus 3, HP, attack, and defense plus 170%, or Universe Survival Saga category, Ki plus 3, HP, attack, and defense plus 150%. Now let's take a quick look at this Universe 11 category. And I will say it is a very, very limited category at the moment. Okay, we literally have 1, 2, 3, this doesn't count because that's the TUR, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 units in the Universe 11 category right now, so exactly enough to make a full team. And if you guys don't have, you know, all 6 of these units, then you can't actually make a full Universe 11 category team. With that said though, all these units are very, very good. Even the free-to-play casserole slash pride troopers. And of course you can combine its Universe 11 leader skill with his Universe Survival Saga leader skill to build a complete team. So it's not really that big of an issue. Now moving on to his super attacks, the 12 key super is Heat Wave Magnetron, causes colossal damage and greatly lowers defense. And the 18 key is Omega Heat Magnetron, causes mega colossal damage, massively lowers defense with a medium chance of stunning the enemy. His passive is attack and defense plus 200%, key plus 1 with each attack received up to 5, attacks effective against all types when the target enemy is in attack down or defense down status, and performs a critical hit when the target enemy is stunned. His active skill is called Strength is Everything, which is a perfect name for Jiren, and it gives him attack and defense plus 30%, all enemies attack and defense minus 30%, and stuns all enemies for one turn, can be activated after the character receives attack 5 times in battle once only. His links are Supreme Warrior, Shocking Speed, Infighter, Godly Power, Tournament of Power, Fierce Battle, and Legendary Power, and categories are Universe Survival Saga, Realm of Gods, Full Power, Universe 11, and Space Traveling Warriors. And lastly, his active skill is calculated separately, so after you use it, he gets a total attack and defense boost of 290%. So there you go guys, that is everything you need to know about Tech LR Jiren. He is just an absolute monster of a unit. He hits super, super, super hard, and he also gets a massive amount of defense on turn one, and he also provides you with good crowd control for events like Super Battle Road, Extreme Super Battle Road, and so on and so forth, with the medium chance to stun on the 18 key super, and also the guaranteed stun to all enemies with his active skill. So this guy is just great for all events. He is, like I said, an absolute monster, and some people might say he's a little bit boring because his kit is not like that unique, but he just destroys everything, and if that's what you want, then he's got you covered. So yeah, there's not really much else for me to say. That's LR Jiren for you. Now let's quickly talk about the Topo Pride Troopers unit. Leader skill, University 11, or Special Pose category, Ki plus 3. HP, attack and defense, plus 120%. Super attack causes supreme damage and lowers attack and defense. And passive is attack and defense, plus 110%, plus an additional attack and defense, plus 110% when there are 3 or more University 11 category allies on the team. Guards against all attacks when there is another University 11 category ally attacking in the same turn. And University 11 category allies, Ki plus 3, attack and defense plus 30%. Links are Supreme Warrior, Signature Pose, Tough as Nails, Hero of Justice, Shocking Speed, Tournament of Power, and Shattering the Limit. And categories are Universe Survival Saga, Joint Forces, Special Pose, University 11, and Space Traveling Warriors. So an amazing support unit for the University 11 category. Once again, a very limited category at the moment, but I'm sure it'll grow in the future. And as long as you have, you know, at least 4 University 11 units on the team, this dude is going to be getting 220% attack and defense, and also guarding against all attacks and providing that support. And the best part is that they can actually be run on the same team as the EZA SDR Topo, since this one is called Topo Bracket Pride Troopers. So yeah, I guess that's all there really is for me to say before I make my recommendation, of course, about whether or not you guys should summon on this banner. But the hope with these videos is that, you know, with the information I give you, you're able to make that decision for yourselves. But if you guys are still, you know, kind of on the fence about all this right now, then I would say it's okay to drop a few multis on this banner. For the average player, maybe, you know, 3 to 4, 150 stones to 200 stones is totally fine. There isn't really anything crazy coming to global in the near future, at least within like, you know, a couple of months. Like the biggest thing, of course, is the anniversary, which is in July, but that is 6 months away, so you have time to save for it. Obviously, that's still the main priority, but once again, it's not happening anytime soon. Now, the next banner I expect to drop on global after Jiren is going to be this one right here for Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. So depending on how badly you want Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, then you might be a little bit more conservative with your stones right now, since he's coming so soon, right? But if you don't care that much about Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta and you actually want, you know, LR Jiren more, then yeah, don't feel too bad about spending a few stones, you know? Like, I think 3 to 4 multis is fine. If you guys have a lot of stones, then maybe do a few more. Don't go too crazy. Obviously, don't spend all your stones. Like, the most I would do if I was a free-to-play player would be 5 to 6 multis, so 250 to 300 stones, and then call it a day. I mean, at the end of the day, it's still a legendary summon banner, right? So it's not really worth that many stones, but for a legendary summon banner, it's not bad, and Jiren is just such a beast that I think this banner is kind of worth it. But of course, that is just my opinion, that is just my recommendation. You guys should do what you want with your stones, whatever you feel like is the best for you. And that's it, guys. That is today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully watching this video helped some of you guys make that summoning decision. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys do plan to summon for Jiren, and if so, how many stones are you going to be dropping? As always, your boy will be live as soon as the banner drops on January 18th at 1:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if you guys want to see those live summons the moment the banner is live, then make sure to tune in. And otherwise, thank you so much for watching. If you liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.